Here is a brief tutorial on how to configure your VS Code to help you declare freest JSON serializable models in the fastest way possible. We are going to create a code snippet for that. First, create a .vscode folder in the root of your project if it doesn't exist yet. Next, create a file with any name and .codesnippets suffix. It uses JSON syntax. First, type in the snippet name, serializable freest model. Next, provide a prefix, fmodel, a description, declare a serializable freest model, and paste this body. Here we have a freest annotation import. Next, we have two part files declared, .freest for freest generator and .g for JSON serializable generator. The future file name is represented by the variable tm file name base. It will be replaced with a real file name when the template is used. Next, we have a freest annotation and the actual class declaration. Here, the future class name is replaced with placeholder number 1. And finally, here is the from JSON factory constructor declaration. The placeholder number 0 on this line here indicates where the cursor is placed after the code snippet is used. Okay, let's now see how to use it. Here is a Dart file called example model. I can start typing our snippet prefix, fmodel, and we immediately see this suggestion with nice description. Hit enter and let's see. Here is a freest annotation import, here are two part files correctly named example model, and here I can type in the model name, example. Now I hit tab and the cursor is conveniently placed inside the constructor, so I can immediately start specifying the model fields. Since I have build runner launched in watch mode in the background, very soon I can see all the part files successfully generated and the model is ready to be used. There is also a way to automatically name the freest class when the snippet is used. For this, replace all instances of placeholder number 1 with this expression, which indicates that the file name in the Pascal case should be used instead. Let's use this code snippet again. As you see, now not only the part files are named automatically, but also the example model class name is provided, so I can immediately work on the model fields.